He's proved he can take a punch. Now he's throwing one of his own. Today on Upfront, Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett on fighting back against negative ads in the governor's race and his recovery 1 year after a brutal attack.
If people go through different trials in their lives, and quite honestly, if I were 20 years old, I'd be more upset with the hand, but I'm getting even closer to middle age, so it's one of these things that you just have to deal with.
They're called issue ads, but who is paying for them? The battle over your right to know, this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gousha.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. We'll have to wait until September 14th to find out which Republican will be on the November ballot for governor, but Democratic candidate Tom Barrett isn't waiting for Republicans to sort it out. He recently launched an ad accusing Scott Walker of being a flip-flopper who can't be trusted. Barrett himself has been on the receiving end of a barrage of attack ads paid for by the Republican Governors Association, accusing him of being just like Jim Doyle, only worse. Our question today, is this a preview of the race to come? We're asking Democratic gubernatorial candidate and Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett. Mayor Barrett, thanks for being back on the program with us.
It's great to be with you, Mike.
I mentioned the Republican Governors Association ads, and they have spent almost $1 million attacking your record as Milwaukee mayor, criticizing you for increases in spending, increases in taxes, and the loss of jobs during the time you were mayor. Are you worried that that first impression for a lot of Wisconsin voters is going to be a lasting impression?
No, and I don't worry about it. And obviously, these are ads that have been running during the summertime when people aren't paying that much attention to this race. But now as we get closer to Labor Day, people will start paying attention. That's why we have responded to point out that this job is a job where you have to have a leader who is willing to make tough decisions. And what we said in our ad was, at least twice, just in the last couple of months, Scott Walker has literally changed his position overnight on issues that are not minor issues, issues like immigration and the smoking ban. And it happened both instances because his primary opponent, Mark Newman, had taken a position further to the right, and so it was almost like a game of leapfrog. And we felt it was important to point that out to the voters. We also felt it was important to point out to the voters that under his leadership, his own budgets as county executive, spending has gone up $380 million. And so since they were saying, well, the spending has gone up under Barrett, we thought, well, we should let people know that under the budgets that Scott Walker has introduced, he has proposed spending increases of $380 million.
Isn't this about, though, raw politics in the sense that they're trying to raise negatives for you, the Republican Governors Association, and you're trying to do the same for Scott Walker, that you have to do that to respond in kind?
Well, I think elections, they're either one of two things. They're either a referendum or they're a choice. And I think they want it to be a referendum on whether people are satisfied. And quite honestly, I'm not satisfied. I'm very angry about the fact that we have hundreds of thousands of people who have been adversely affected by this economic downturn. People have lost their jobs. Their hours have been reduced. I'm not happy about that. And so if it's a referendum, I'm not happy. But elections ultimately are choices, and they're choices between individuals. And so it's imperative that I let people know that Scott Walker, on major decisions, literally overnight changed his position, and that notwithstanding his claims to the contrary, that his own budgets have increased spending by $380 million. So I think it's important that we have that conversation.
Why do this now? The primary's not even over.
Well, I think it's clear that the Republican establishment, because the ads are paid for by the Republican Governors Association, and perhaps I should be flattered because I think we're one of a very few number of states that the Republican Governors Association are spending this type of money. And they're doing so because they're concerned about me. And you're right, they want to soil my reputation before I have a chance to be well known. And so it is important.
What in those ads, though, is untrue? What they say, higher taxes, higher spending, and jobs lost during your time as mayor.
Well, I think what's misleading about it is that certainly during the time I've been mayor, we have had balanced budgets every single year. This year we have a surplus. I'm very proud of the fact that we've had a surplus. We have achieved that without going out and borrowing $400 million like Scott Walker did for the pension system. And so I'll go to any business in the state, I'll go to any family in the state and say, would you rather have a leader who balanced the budget, or would you rather have someone who kicked the can down the road, didn't make the tough decision, and then posed for the holy picture? Because my budget this year for 2010 in levy terms could actually be lower than it was when I came into office 6 years ago if I had done what Scott Walker had done. I could have just borrowed that money for our pension system and then posed for the holy picture. But I think people are mad right now. They're mad because they think at the federal level, at the state level, at the county level, politicians are not making difficult decisions. And instead, they're kicking the can down the road and again, posing for the holy pictures. I didn't do that.
Let's talk about one of those difficult decisions. And the Walker campaign has tried to raise this issue. Recently, he called you the state's biggest polluter. He said back in 2004, when you were a candidate for mayor, you said you would take steps to deal with the dumping of untreated sewage into Lake Michigan. You'd kind of ride herd on the Metropolitan Sewerage District Commission to make sure it performed better. And he says you failed to live up to those promises. Your campaign said that was shameless, given the tragic circumstances of the flooding here. But my question is, why is it shameless? Why isn't that a relevant topic for discussion if you are talking about effective leadership?
Oh, I think it's important to talk about what steps we have taken. And I'm more than happy to say that since I came into office, what we did do is we did revamp that commission. They were getting insurance, exclusive insurance for commissioners that had a very part-time job. We took that away immediately. We changed the contracting function so that they couldn't have sole source contracting. We've added 28% capacity to the sewer system in 6 years. But the irony of ironies is that if you go out to Wauwatosa right now, there's a 315 million gallon basin that could have been in place this last week or this last month when we had those floods. But it was Scott Walker as county executive who wanted an independent analysis before that went forward several years ago. So that delayed that. So here he's talking about the problems. He's part and parcel of the delay of the largest expansion to this system in the last 20 years. And again, I've got to tell that to people. People have to understand that part of what's going on here is that he felt that he got burned because he left this city 36 hours after we had the most serious flooding we've had in years here to go do campaign parades. And he got smacked for doing that.
You think you've lived up to the promises you made in 2004 as a candidate?
Oh, I think that we are continuing to work to live up to those promises. I do want to see the number of discharges into the lake reduced, and we're going to continue to do that. But it takes more than just one city. There are 28 communities in the MMSD area. And again, ironically, Scott Walker presides over 39 miles of sewers. I've never, and I mean never, once seen him attend an MMSD meeting, ever.
I want to talk about jobs. That's what you hear about out on the campaign trail. That's what the other candidates hear about. Give me your sales pitch, because ultimately, whoever wins this race for governor is going to have to sell the people of Wisconsin on the idea that they are the right person to help create an atmosphere that is conducive to creating jobs. What is your sales pitch?
Well, my sales pitch is I think it's important that the governor be the number one salesperson, cheerleader, ambassador for the state. And that means you've got to like the state. And I'd love the state. And I want to be the salesperson for this job. But I don't think you sell a suit. I don't think you sell a car by saying how lousy it is. And on the other side, you've got several candidates who spend all their time saying how lousy things are in the state of Wisconsin. Let me give you a real-world example of how we dealt with this issue. Republic Airlines, last year when they purchased Midwest, I was sitting in my office with the CEO of the corporation, and he said now that had been accomplished, they were going to make a decision where to locate some back office jobs, some mechanics jobs and others. And I said, well, we want to be in the mix. And he said, you can compete. You'll be competing with Indianapolis and Denver. I said, great. So we put forth a proposal through the M7, the Milwaukee 7, that dealt with tax credits tied to job creation, site location, getting workers. There was an article in the Indianapolis newspaper that just dismissed us, said it's between Indianapolis and Denver. At the end of the day, we ran the table. We saved all the jobs here, got 700 jobs from Denver and Indianapolis. That didn't happen by accident. That happened because we were proactive, we were aggressive, and we talked about the good things about Wisconsin rather than how bad things are. That's the type of approach that I want to take.
President Obama will be in Milwaukee on Monday for a fundraiser on your behalf. Is that wise to be that closely associated with the president, whose latest popularity rankings, I think, according to CNN, were 47%? Thought he was doing a good job, 50% didn't. Is that wise on your part?
Oh, I'm pleased to have him here. And I realize the president has come in at the most difficult economic times in this nation's history, at least in the last 60 years. And people they're frustrated because he hasn't gotten the car out of the ditch fast enough in terms of the economy. But I think people forget who got the car in the ditch. It wasn't his policies. It was frankly the policies of George Bush that got the car in the ditch.
And you welcome him back during the campaign? You'd like to campaign with him more?
I'd be happy to have him here. But just to let you know what a bipartisan guy I am, I'd be happy to have George Bush here as well.
Final question. A year ago, we were talking about the attack that you suffered leaving State Fair Park. You were badly beaten, and here we are a year later. And my question is, obviously, your hand is still undergoing therapy, and you're recovering from your physical injuries, but how has that incident affected your campaign? Has it affected your campaign? Or you as a campaigner?
I still spend a lot of time in occupational therapy. I'm trying to get more use out of the hand. I don't know that I hope it hasn't had a negative impact on me as a person. I think that people go through different trials in their lives, and quite honestly, if I were 20 years old or a great athlete or a great musician, I'd be more upset with the hand, but I'm getting even closer to middle age, so it's one of these things that you just have to deal with. And it's the way I approach life. I just deal with it. Those are the cards that are dealt to me. I'm going to deal with it.
All right. Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett, Democratic candidate for governor. We appreciate you being with us today.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Mike.
Is it a victory for free speech or a blow to transparency in elections? The controversy over issue ads. Next on Upfront.
The clean energy company about to get a presidential visit. When Upfront continues.
Upfront with Mike Gousha, brought to you by American Transmission Company and the Wisconsin Corn Growers Association.